Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's a girl, Sophia Glow. Sophia Glow, it's yeah, just like her face is glowing. Yeah, I'm here with another video for you guys, and it's a very interesting topic we're going to talk about. Well, I just want to update you guys about how Rachel Otieno is faring. You guys must have known Rachel Otieno for now. She was the Kenyan girl that just got separated from her boyfriend Eric. They both live in Sweden. She was the Kenyan girl that just got separated from her boyfriend. So guys, I just want to update you guys about how she's faring now. Yeah, she made a video yesterday, and she was trying to tell her fans and her supporters and her subscribers how she's faring, you know. And I really like the fact that she could come out to talk about how she's doing. You know, she talked about some few things, like how she has been able to cope and she has been able to manage this breakup that she just went through the help of our friends, our very good friends. You know, sometimes you pray for good friends that will be there for you when you're down, you know. So she showed appreciation to our friends that they have been the ones, you know, carrying helping her to pass through this separation saga that she just went through with the guy, and she thanked them. And then she talked about how she enjoyed every bit of the relationship, even though it didn't lead into marriage. Yeah, it's not all relationship that should lead into marriage, do you understand? You know, and she also talked about how she really experienced, she knew that she was in love in that relationship, that she was in, she knew she was real, she wasn't faking anything, she was really in love with the guy, just that it didn't work out as she was expecting. And she also talked about the fact that she gave an example of Romeo and Juliet, that everybody could see that, everybody knew that Romeo and Juliet didn't end up in marriage, you know, things didn't work out the way they wanted also. So it's not all relationship that should lead into marriage. That she talked about how she enjoyed every bit of the time she spent with the guy, and how she's not regretting anything. And she tried to also talk about some questions that were asked, you know, some questions that were asked by some of our subscribers. She tried also to address a few of those questions, like the one that there is somebody wrote and asked her that was she with Henry just basically because of the paper that she wanted to get from him. And she tried to address that question as best as she could. She tried to tell us that she didn't stay with Eric because she wanted to get papers from him. If, on the contrary, Eric even slowed a process of getting the papers, you know, because she had to wait 2 years again before she was able to finally get her papers, you know, that she didn't pursue her papers. Instead, she was pursuing love, you know, which I wouldn't blame her. You know, everybody's looking for love, do you understand? So she said she pursued love instead of pursuing a paper, that they shouldn't even think about it, that you know, she was into the relationship because of love. She was because of papers, she was actually in that relationship because she was in love with a guy for real, you know. And also she talked about how she's trying to, you know, make herself look good because it's not the end of the world, how she's how she has gone to do Botox on her face, you know, so that she was just trying to make fun, even though you could see that as she was talking, that you could still feel the pain in her. Of course, it's not easy, you know, coming out of a broken relationship. You could still feel the pain and you could still feel the love the way she was talking, because that was how I was feeling. I was really feeling that intensity in her, that she, you know, she was still in love with the guy, no doubt. You know, she's still in love with the guy, no doubt. You know, but you know, as time progresses, I know she's gonna go out of that feeling for the guy, you know. So I like the fact that she could come out and she could talk about it openly to subscribers, to let them know what she's, you know, going through and at what stage she is right now, you know. So she also talked about how she also wanted to look good, try to keep herself sane, so that the next man that will come her way, you know, we see that she's still there, she's beautiful, she's not looking wrinkled because she just came out of a broken relationship, you know, and all that. So I really enjoyed watching that particular video of us, which I'm going to, you know, definitely leave a clip down so that you guys can also see, you know, what I'm talking about and how she said these things and all that. So I'm so happy that she could let me tell you guys, she also talked about how she could have been inside the house, you know, crying. She had been crying herself, you know, she could cry herself for 2-3 days, but because of her friends, you know, strong bond that she has with her friends, she was able to, like, you know, pick up the pieces of her life and, you know, dust her feet and start all over again, which she's doing right now. She's starting all over again, you know. That's not going to weigh her down and all that. So I'm so happy that, you know, she's doing all those things, all this fun thing, you know, to just take her mind off this relationship. It's a good thing. I'm so happy for her. Richa is a smart girl. She's an intelligent girl. She's a fun girl, you know. So nothing should kill her joy. You know, you understand? Nothing should. We shouldn't even allow anything to kill our joy. Not only Richa. We shouldn't even allow anything to kill our joy. If a relationship does not work out, doesn't mean it's the end of the world. You know, it probably means that this person is not meant for us. You know, we'd definitely meet our partners, you know, the right people as we go further in life, you know. So we should just be focused and, you know, yeah. That's all I think I have to say. So, if you're just passing by my channel for the first time, you're highly welcome. Please, before you run along, don't forget to click on the red sign and also on the notification. What am I saying? And also on the notification bell, so you get notified whenever I make a new video. Be the first to know. So, and also to my old subscribers. You guys are highly appreciated. Thank you guys for always coming back. And I'm gonna leave you guys now, and I will see you all in my next video. For now, it's goodbye and God bless. Stay safe and watch out for my next video. Bye all. Bye, lovely people.
I recently made a video telling you of my, you know, answering your questions, your burning questions, and I got a lot of interesting reactions, most of very positive and of course opinions and stuff, which is totally fine as expected. And I must say that even though at heart I know that of course this was right, that is this, like, what I'm doing is right, it just feels like, you know, when breaking the news felt like, you know, telling your kids. I cannot imagine how much harder breakups are when people have children and then all of a sudden they have to, like, they go through this phase where, you know, it's a really weird phase. You guys, breakups are weird, like, it's just weird. One moment you're friends, your best friends, the next moment you just start to kick each other. Oh, God. And as much as I'm laughing about myself right now, it's kind of funny. Like, you know, I just sit down and look at myself, like, wow, girl, you're pulling this out. Like, yeah. But honestly, I must say that I don't think I would have managed this without my 3 amazing sweet friends. Chiro, Hura, Janet. You guys, you're right here. You've pulled me and pulled me through this. I love you guys. Anyway, so guys, one thing, that the reason why I actually thought of making this small content, other than the fact that I actually did my makeup and I showered, it's, well, because I went through like a dirty phase, guys. I went through a dirty phase, you guys. I think I was just laying in my bed for 2 days straight. I was like, oh my God, may this come past me. I don't want to feel like I feel. But now today, at least I managed to shower, I did my makeup, and I thought, let me just come and speak to you guys for a second. And the thing is, I see, like, some of you are just... So I get this thing, someone saying, oh, Rachel, did you just use Henrik for papers and for travel and stuff? And I'm like, oh my God, guys, are you serious? How can you say that? Like, how can you say that when it's so obvious how much I love this guy? Wasn't it obvious? No, guys, it's so crazy because when I just think about papers, I did not get my papers on time because I decided to pursue love, you know. I had figured out how I was going to get my papers and everything, but then because Henry came into the picture, I let go that, and I decided to be with him again. So which means my papers process was delayed. And I think one day I'll come give you like the entire story properly. But that's what happened. So honestly, guys, I was never... Being with Henry for purpose would be the most counterproductive thing that I could, like, anyone who's just thinking, okay, I only want my purpose, you wouldn't do that. Especially if you know how the system works, you wouldn't do that. And I did it, but I did it because of love, honestly. And then, the thing to do with traveling, right? Like, how can you say that when it's so obvious how much I love this guy? Wasn't it obvious? No, guys, it's so crazy because when I just think about purpose, I did not get my papers on time because I decided to pursue love, you know? I had figured out how I was going to get my papers and everything. But then because Henry came into the picture, I let go that and I decided to be with Henry again. So which means my papers process was delayed. And I think one day I'll come give you like the entire story properly. But that's what happened. So honestly, guys, I was never... Being with Henry for purpose would be the most counterproductive thing that I could, like, anyone who's just thinking, okay, I only want my purpose, you wouldn't do that. Especially if you know how the system works, you wouldn't do that. And I did it, but I did it because of love, honestly. And then the thing to do with traveling, right? You guys, I don't know if you don't, I don't know if you realize this, but for 2 years, I was not able to leave Sweden. I was not able to go anywhere. I was stuck in this country, guys.